This is a procedure of septal resection. As you can see here, I'm using the rectoscope, and this is a monopolar cautery with the glycine as the distension media. The septum is a deep one. It is extending almost till the internal os, and it is fibrous, as you can see here. This is an unedited video at a speed of 2x. And you can see that I'm taking very small bites slowly and I'm cutting it. So this is very important, where when we are using the energy source, we have to use small bursts of energy, and we should do it millimeter by millimeter till we make sure that the ostia, both of them, are seen in the panoramic view. Also, important point to note here is, like, we should make sure the input and output of the distension agent is monitored, and there shouldn't be any air bubbles when we are trying to do this. So doing the procedure quickly is very important, aligning the rectoscope properly with the septum, because each case is unique, and the septum could be either a broad one or a narrow one like this, and it could be indentation in the fundus also could be a problem sometimes, and perforation also is a possibility. So here, once I finish this resection, postoperatively, I'm going to put the patient on Foley's catheter, pediatric number 8 Foley's, and I will remove it after 5 days. I don't usually put intercede or anything. I will put her on estrogen progesterone supplementation for 3 months, and then she can try for pregnancy. This patient is a case of primary infertility who has not conceived even once, and there was a confusion about bicornuate and septate uterus, and on 3D and also in HSG, I could diagnose that it was a septate uterus. So this whole procedure we could finish in 5 to 6 minutes. And also, we did not do a laparoscope for this patient because it was quite evident and it was very clear. So when I'm not using the energy source, you can see here that I'm just gently pushing this rectoscope manually to separate the fibers like this, as you can see here. Having the right kind of instruments is very important. This is a 2.9 mm scope with a 4 mm operative sheath. So this procedure went very well. Patient is discharged after 4 hours.